base zone in Zambia is just a stone's throw away from the city centre. The area, which is about 1 acre, houses over 900 Karamojongs. These left their home districts in pursuit of a better life, but ended up on the streets, which for decades have acted as their sole source of livelihood. This area is a beehive of activities including making charcoal stoves and rat traps by the male residents, while some females who have given up on begging have resorted to making local brew, commonly known as malwa, while others hawk the men's produce.
This one is 7,000. This is 5,000.
The area is covered by makeshift structures, each housing over 20 people. During a visit, we encountered one household headed by 15-year-old Sharifa Nakwaya, who is also a mother to two. According to Nakwaya, she and most of the girls in the area were trafficked from their home district to come and beg on the streets. After years of sleeping on the streets, they were impregnated by strangers. We were brought from the village thinking we were going to get jobs, but we ended up on streets begging. After some time, I got pregnant. Nakwaya's household is only one torn mattress and a rugged blanket which covers the 12 infants in the household. She narrates their ordeal during rainy seasons.
We spend the whole night squatting in corners.
These also gave up the luxury of real food except gathering chicken offals, while the lucky ones are able to get rejected cereals from shops and markets.
I wish government or anyone gets us something to eat. Many of us survive on garbage.
For the mothers, their duty is to wake the toddlers and assign them the day's role, which is begging, while throughout the day they keep watch over the little ones to keep any coin that may be donated by a passerby. Many of these long for basics such as education for their children, but have on several occasions been fleeced by NGOs, while those who chance upon scholarships are often overwhelmed by the cost of the scholastic materials needed. Besides the streets, some earn the money from simple business like making charcoal stoves, which they hawk in the city. With the proceeds, each is able to save about 2,000 a week in the savings club. Their only prayer is that the Kampala Capital City Authority stops harassing them and instead allocate a market for their products.
Because now only you just go and roll it like that. You want to look for us a market. So that one you make is there that there's a market for that company.
Just like in other overpopulated areas, base zone faces a number of challenges, including high crime rates. Epidemic diseases like cholera and typhoid have claimed many, especially the children, while HIV/AIDS is also on the loose due to high rates of sexual abuse in the area. Homelessness in Uganda has gone up, with over 3% of the urban population living on streets. Today, Uganda joined the rest of the world to commemorate World Population Day, and the theme was investing in the teenage girls. Here in Uganda, the girl child remains vulnerable to inaccessibility to basic needs like education, while others are sexually assaulted, leading to child parents and HIV/AIDS cases. Report compiled by Rachel Nachwala for Urban TV.